Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm really excited to do a day in the life today because it's actually a spa day in the life, which really never happens, but I'm hoping this is something that's going to happen frequently this year. It's one of my intentions for the year. So as I'm vlogging this day, I actually want to start with packing my spa bag. I actually had my assistant take the lead on a project to source things that I would need for a spa day so that I could have a spa bag ready. So it'd be one less barrier to me doing this with a bit more frequency. And today I'm going to be spa-ing at Burke Williams. I got a gift card from Kofi for my birthday last November. In November, I actually had chicken pox. I had adult chicken pox. No, I never had it as a child. It was completely terrible. I've also had malaria. Chicken pox is way worse. I don't wish it on anybody. But my husband so sweetly got me this gift card to Burke Williams, figuring wisely that I would want to invest more time in my skincare after chickenpox. You can see I have like a couple of chickenpox scars that are making me feel a little self-conscious, but it wasn't as bad as it could have been, so I'm happy about that. So I have all these great items that I'm gonna kind of go through one by one, but I'm going to just even point out this awesome spa bag that I have. This is the bag that I'm gonna be using. I feel like it just has spa vibes, and it actually is from Costa Palmas, which is this amazing new development, resort development, 30 minutes away from Cabo in Mexico, that's anchored by a Four Seasons hotel. Amazing, beautiful luxury. Of course, this is something that I got through my husband, who does luxury real estate for athletes and entertainers here in Beverly Hills and actually kind of globally. So this is my great bag that's big, that's gonna hold a lot of this stuff. So yeah, the first thing going in the bag is the gift card, because I want to make sure I have that when I show up there. The next thing I'm popping in my bag is just this carry-all from Louis Vuitton. It came with my Neverfull. I will do a what's in my Neverfull video soon enough, but I'm just going to take this out. It pretty much has mainly just my cash, a lipstick, a couple things, so I'm just going to throw that with me, throw that in the bag. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to be popping in my bag are actually a couple of books. Yes, books. Okay, so, and my 5-star pencil case that has pens, pencils, highlighters, and correction tape. This is Atomic Habits. I am going to be doing a what's in my purse, what am I reading now? So I just wanna go back through it and highlight a couple more things so that I have kind of a coherent review for you guys. So I'm popping that in my bag. And then I also got this journal. It's called The Power of Now. I purchased one also from my good friend Beate. She hosted a vision boarding party that was all about intention setting for the coming year and kind of the coming decade. But my word of the year is now, as was her word of the year. So I got this for both of us, and I haven't had time to journal in it on a regular basis, but I figured that it'd be really nice to try to consistently do a few of the exercises while I'm at my spa days, which I'm hoping to do once a month. So again, a lot of the stuff that I have is just kind of totally brand new because my assistant just sourced all of these things for me. So I am going to, well, most of these things, she sourced most of these things. I'm actually going to put a couple of things into this bag. This is a really beautiful little bag that's made out of an African fabric that I got at an event that I went to recently that was co-hosted by Pauline Malcolm Thornton and Melinda Williams, the actress Melinda Williams, and this was in the gift bag for that event. And so what I'm going to do is just take this little Isaac Mizrahi nail set and pop that in there. And hopefully I can do it without damaging my own nails. All right, I might need to get scissors, hang on. Okay, I've got scissors, which I probably am gonna need to open up a few things. So this is just a little nail kit. It's really cute with polka dots. I'm just gonna drop it in there so that I have it for my day. And also just some Palmer's coconut oil lip balm. So I need that too, can't go wrong. I will also just cut this open and pop it in this little bag. If I have space, which I believe I do, I'm also gonna throw in this white peach kind of shampoo body wash from Philosophy. Now, I think she got a lot of these things actually at Nordstrom Rack and Marshall's is what she told me. So she got them and I just paid for it. But it's great to have an assistant. I actually have a whole video that I'm going to be posting for you about the benefits of having a personal assistant. So actually, again, this spa day is made possible in part by my husband, not just because he got me this great gift card to the spa that I plan to use, but also because he dropped off both of our kids this morning, so I had time to do a couple of things around the house and get myself ready and make this video. So he's leaving for work a little later than usual, but there he is. Thank you. Thank you. Have a great day. Okay, I had to just, one more kiss for Kofi, see him off. All right, so back to this. Of course, Neutrogena makeup remover wipes. I need to even take off. I put on a little makeup this morning because I was doing a couple of videos, but don't need makeup for the spa. So there's that. Oh, I love this little baggie that Kofi got me at, I think it was JW Marriott Resort in Palm Springs. It says emotional baggage. It's super cute. So I'm also gonna be tossing that in there. Really what I have in here is some foundation and some essential oils for pain, anxiety, nervousness, stress relief. So I just have those two things. And I also have this beautiful little card holder that I got, and I have to do a travel vlog about our trip to the Navajo reservation in Arizona to see one of my best friends and to participate in her niece's Canalda. So Canalda is a coming of age ceremony for Navajo girls. It was such a life-changing, beautiful experience, and I definitely will be doing a travel vlog about that. But one of her aunts gave me this as I was leaving as a gift, super special to me. And I just have a couple of cards in here that I'm taking with me. All right, let me move the rest of this stuff closer. So I have to reach, even though I have long arms. So a couple of other pretty simple things that I have a little cuddle blanket. This actually also came from my Costa Palmas gift bag, but it's just a Mexican beach blanket that I'm gonna use to snuggle down under with my books when I get there, my books and my journal. So that's going in the bag. And in the snuggle down theme, I also have some cozy socks because I'm going to probably wear flip-flops out there. It's a little cold. There's an outside chance that I might wear UGG boots because when I say it's a little cold, I mean it's like below 70 in LA. So that might warrant UGGs. And if I get cold when I'm there, I'm just gonna get these socks. And these are actually new socks that I got from the Pendry Hotels that Kofi's also working with. I also have this jaw clip that my assistant grabbed for me, which is going to be important so I can pull my hair back. Something I don't have here, but I'll probably grab is also a headband just to make sure that I can keep my hair out of my face while I'm there. Hopefully they'll have some stuff, but just in case, I'll grab another one. So the last several things here are really to be consumed because honestly, let's face it, as a mom, just eating your own food and snacks is a luxury. So if I want to have a luxurious day, I just need to pack the snacks that I like. I have some of these Ghirardelli dark chocolate sea salt squares. They're amazing, and I'll be honest, I already opened the bag and had a couple the other night, but I'm just gonna throw these into my spa bag. I also have this great detox tea glass bottle that my assistant grabbed for me. So what's so nice about this is it has a little infuser in it. Here we go. All right, so it has this little tea infuser. So you can use it as a water bottle, as an infuser, but you can actually use it for hot tea. And it's by Apana, which is a yoga lifestyle brand. And I have some of my favorite tea to infuse from Charles & Company. This is an amazing brand of organic and kosher teas. This is one of my favorites, the Indian chai, but there's so many that are so good. Lawrence Charles is a good dear friend of Kofi and I's, and we absolutely love his teas. When I have events that are kind of brunch events or daytime events or some women's events, I love to use his teas, so highly recommend. All right, so I'm taking this with me. There'll probably also be some green tea at the spa, hopefully. Of course, just a bottle of water. There should be a bottle of water there, but just for me on the way in or on the way out, toss in a bottle of water. I've got a Kind Bar probiotic breakfast bar. I actually haven't had a full breakfast this morning, so I will probably be eating this on the way in. And then finally, this is so adorable, a teeny tiny bottle of Moët champagne for me to take. Hopefully, I'll be able to take this in on my own. Kofi brought this for me. He was at an event somewhere, actually, interestingly, and they had a Moët champagne vending machine. My assistant actually had brought me a pack of La Marca Proseccos, but I'll just save these for my next spa days. I'm gonna go with the Moët today. And then this is kind of cumbersome, but I am taking it with me. This is this amazing True Medic neck massager that we got at Costco. And I'm telling you, this thing saves lives. I'm not getting a massage treatment today. As I said, I'm gonna do kind of facial skin stuff. That's what I'm focused on until I can get my skin back to normal and treat the scars from my chicken pox. But I'm going to take this so that I can still kind of work out some kinks while I'm at the spa, enjoying myself, taking full advantage of the day. So before I take off, I just want to talk again a little bit about the logistics of this spa day that I'm doing for myself. My goal is to try to go once every 4 to 6 weeks to just decompress and have some time away. Surprisingly, I'm actually introverted. So what that really means is that I need time to myself to rejuvenate. And especially since I started homeschooling my daughter part-time, I'm just realizing that I have less alone time to recharge. So this is the solution that I came up with, actually with Kofi's help, as I said. He gave me a little bit of prompting to make sure I got this done. But my daughter goes to school, her drop-off's at 9:15. Kofi did it today so I could have a little extra time. I am going to, it's almost 10 o'clock, I'm going to head out now. I have an actual skin treatment appointment at noon, but I'm gonna go hang out, rest, and stay till hopefully around 2 o'clock. Or just before 2 o'clock, where I will, and then I'll come back and pick up Lincoln. So that's my plan to kind of make the most of this day, a Thursday that I have typically to myself because my daughter in her homeschool hybrid program goes to school on Mondays and Thursdays. So that's pretty much everything. It's time to get this spa day started. Much needed, guys. So I did also grab a hairbrush and some deodorant, which I realized I was missing from my bag. And then it occurred to me, like, I should ask you guys any other suggestions for what I might be taking with me to the spa, since I'm trying to have this bag kind of packed and ready to go mostly. GPS is telling me, how long is it gonna take? Let me see. 24 minutes. I almost got sucked into like doing some more laundry and other things, but I realized like that defeats the point. I need to just leave the house and go and have my day. I need to go. I need to leave. I need to leave everything else behind. But you guys know how hard that is. So 24 minutes. So this is 24 minutes. Actually, it went up to 26 minutes to go about 5.5 miles. Just to give you context, if you're not from LA, what life is like driving around the city. Just to talk about some of the things going on in my life right now and why I'm seeking a little bit of relief. Besides this transition that I'm trying to make to YouTubing, I still have a couple of carryover or holdover responsibilities from academia. I'm still working on a couple of research-related things that I'm trying to withdraw from. I am also preparing for State Cup this weekend. I coach my daughter's club soccer team. As I mentioned before, I am doing the homeschool hybrid for my daughter, so we are up to our necks in two courses that we're doing at home that are new courses. One is Speeches That Change the World, and the other one is a botany class. I'm team teaching with another friend. We have a collaborative going, and that's besides the other, you know, math and reading work that we're trying to keep her engaged in. Actually, we also have her in a program through the Center for Lit. It's just an online course, an online literature course, so that's been really great in alleviating some of the obligation on me to come up with so many different assignments for so many different subjects. I am learning that some things can and should be outsourced. It's more ideal, and it's just good for her to have the experience to take an online course, because of course, that is the way forward for education. I mentioned that the mother-son dance is coming up tomorrow night. So Lincoln and I are going to do that. Just in general, you know, managing the work with Lincoln, making sure that he's getting what he needs emotionally. He's a bit more of an introverted kid too. So it's, you know, it's amazing how you have two different kids. They're completely different personalities. And just when you start to feel, it's like the joke, when you start to feel like you get the hang of it with one kid, you have this other kid and they're totally different. So I have the stuff going on with him. It's almost time for us to start really digging into our planning for this year's Narche Sports Foundation Gala. So that's something that is about to ramp up for me also. Next week is Laya's birthday. She's turning 11. So we are actually not having her birthday party until the end of the month. My assistant is helping me organize that. We're not having it until the end of the month because of the State Cup soccer tournament. Basically, most of her friends that she wants to invite to the party are on the soccer team. So we're going to wait till this tournament is over in order to celebrate her fully. But she and I have also decided and committed to doing an act of community service on her birthday. So for the first 10 years of her life, I celebrated her birthday. I designed and organized parties in the theme of a different country for both her and for Lincoln. And that was like a 10-year stretch. But now that she's turning 11, she has the freedom to have a different kind of birthday party, whatever she wants to do that's not necessarily consumed by the theme of a country. And we are going to help her make an impact on the world on the day of her birth. So that's what we're going to be doing for the next 10 years or however long she's going to be with us or near us so that we can celebrate her life in that way. Life is short. That's something that we've definitely learned, and we just want to make sure that we make the most of every day, and I want to instill that value in her. You know, first it was, I really want to instill in her a passion and an open-mindedness, passion for diversity and an open-mindedness for different cultures and different people and different places in the world, and as a spirit of wonder, a healthy spirit of wonder. So that was what the first decade was about, and I think that we've been really successful with that. And I'm going to do a vlog next week as we have her birthday unfold, just covering that and explaining that in greater detail. And I'm looking forward to this new adventure of doing some acts of community service. So we are going to go into downtown LA, and this first act of community service is going to be in support of the homeless population. So these are the things that are on the agenda. Oh, and of course, next week, Kofi is going to be a participant in an award show in Beverly Hills at the Four Seasons. He has been nominated for the Social Media Superstars Award in the International Real Estate category. So I'm also prepping for a great Get Ready With Me video for that. I've got to figure out exactly what I want to wear, and hopefully it'll fall also eventually into one of my five favorite looks videos down the line. Yeah, so actually that sounds great. I'm really excited to hear about that. That's going to be, you know, awesome dynamic for your business.
No, for sure. For sure. The kind of leverage that just makes total sense on both sides.
Right.
You know, it's still staying focused in my lane and bringing all the right people to help me in the other lane that kind of feed the flywheel. So, all good.
Amazing. Well, off to a good Thursday. Get it, get it, get it. All right, I will. All right, I'll talk to you later. Okay, bye. So parking in Santa Monica kind of sucks. So I parked, but I think I parked a little too soon. And now I'm walking down to the Burke Williams Spa. So that was a very successful spa day. I had Judea at Burke Williams give me an amazing facial, just what I needed. I think it was like a four-layer resurfacing, something like that, something to do with resurfacing to get myself healed up from these scars. So that was awesome. And now I'm leaving just in time to go and pick up Lincoln from school and then pick up Laya from school and start our after school routine, which isn't so crazy for Thursdays because as of right now, Lincoln's not in soccer and Laya doesn't have soccer practice tonight. So it should be pretty chill with just homework and making dinner. Okay, so we are actually just waiting for Laya. We're at her school. We're gonna go through the valet. I've already picked up Lincoln. And we're just talking about what we have to do today. When we get home, we are going to work on an essay that you have to write. And then we're also gonna start working on making your Valentine's Day box in the shape of a what?
A dragon.
A dragon. You have an idea in your head? What do you want it to be like? You don't want to say it out loud, it's scary. Okay.
Well, I'm not going
to
say it.
All right, so we'll just have to check back in to see how it turns out later. Okay?
But Laya brought back some Girl Scout cookies.
Yeah, I gave her some money for some Girl Scout cookies today.
Guess what, Mommy?
What?
Me and Hunter are gonna buy Dress and Play's merchandise.
Did you turn this on?
No.
So we're almost home. We picked up Laya from school. And as I said, spa day is kind of officially over and we're moving into homework time. So it was a great day. I think it's gonna actually be a really great evening. Because I'm feeling relaxed and it sounds like the kids had a good day. Yeah, you guys had a good day?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's that for today. On to the next.